Yes, in this video, we are going to see about the ordered doubly linked list. So, what is a doubly linked list and why we call it so? That already we have seen the theory. A doubly linked list has three fields, mainly the information field and two address field. The one which is before this information field is pointing to the previous node location. As well as this is pointing to the next node location. Initially, when you create a node, they will be made as both the locations, that is previous and next, will be made null. So this is our structure of the, initially we create the structure node to consist of that is information field which we have given here, and then two pointers. This is next and the previous, PREV. Then we create a class called OLL, indicating that is ordered doubly linked list. Then we have declared two pointers which are of type node. They are head and tail, where the head points the first node of the doubly linked list and the tail points the last node of the doubly linked list. So for that we have declared two pointers called head and tail, and this is the constructor. Initially, head and tail here both are made to null, indicating there is no node at all. Okay, so when both are pointing to null, which means there is no node and the list is said to be empty. Now, these are all the member functions: is full, empty, insertion, deletion, search, traverse, update, destroy, and reverse. Is full. So, how you will check is full? In array, you can check if it has reached the maximum length of the array. If you are going to use array as a linked list structure, you can check, because already you should have declared maximum length, and if it has reached maximum length, then you can say there is no space, the array, it is full, all the data is full. But how you can check in a memory location? So by creating a node, and if you are able to create, then you can say, and it has a memory location, then you can say some space is there. So that is what here we are doing. We are declaring a temporary pointer which is of type node, and then we use the new operator to create the temporary node here like this. If it is created, then okay, or else if temp is equal to null means there is no space, this node is not able to create. So in that case, it returns once, indicating that the memory is full, so you cannot add node. So else it returns, else it delete the temp, because we have just in order to check only we have created. So now we delete the temp and return 0, indicating that there is space for new node creation. Then is empty. When how you will check empty? When there is a node in a doubly linked list, whether a node is there or not, that is what we are going to do here. So how you can declare doubly linked list to be empty when the head is equal to null? So here, like this, it is not pointing into any newly created linked list. There is no node. So in that case, it will be pointing to null. So in that case, it returns a 1, or else it returns a 0. If there are some nodes, then head will be definitely pointing to the first node. In that case, it is no more pointing to a null. It is pointing to some memory location. In that case, it will return 0, indicating that the list is not empty. Now, searching a node, because before insertion deletion, we have to check this function. But this we are going to use it in our insertion deletion. So, searching a node in a doubly linked list. So for that, what we do is we pass the data to be searched. Suppose I am going to search for 20 means that I am passing here. Then two pointer we are going to keep track, previous and current. So two pointers, so that when this search location is returned, it will return both the current as well as the previous location, because two pointer manipulation we have to do, both the next and the previous. So what we are going to do is we are going to return the current location. Suppose 20 is the one which I am searching, it will return the current location, which is nothing but 101, and its previous location is for this 100, that also it will return. So that is the logic of this program. So first what we do is, if here we are making previous equal to null, initially we make previous equal to null, so it is pointing nothing. Then current is made to point to this head. Current is made to point to initially, so it is made to point here, it is made to point null. Okay, so what happens, initially they have been made like this, and then we go inside the while loop. While current is reaching the end of the list, how you will, it will if, after this reading this, it will go to the next, then this current will be made to loops. When the current is moving to the next location, the previous node is pointing to this. Then when the current is pointing to the next location, the previous is made to point to this, that is previous node of the current. That is what the logic. So while current is not equal to, until it reaches the end of the list, and s data is the searching data, till it is greater than the current data. Let us imagine we are going to search for 30. We are going to find the value 30. Now what happens? Initially, the previous is made to null and current is made to point to the head. Then while current is not equal to null, it is not equal to null. So now the current is made to point to the next. So now it is made to point this. In that case, what happened? The previous is becoming, is made to point to this. Okay, now it is made to point to this. Now next, it is checking this, is it s data is greater than current data. Here itself it checked 10 is smaller, so only it is moved here. Now again here we check whether it is greater than, yeah, 30 is greater than, 30 is greater than the current data. So what happened? Now you have to go inside the while loop. Now previous is equal to current. Now this is moved. Now this previous, this is no more previous, head is pointing here. We are not changing the head pointer. Then previous is made to point this according to this statement. Now previous is made to point to this, and current is made to point to the current next, which is nothing but 102. So now the current is, yes, now the current is made to point to this location. Okay, yes, now it is pointing this according to this. Now again, while current is not equal to, yes, it is not equal, current is not equal to null, and yes, data is greater than current data. The searching data is nothing but our 30. Now we are searching for 30. No, it is not greater than, but it is equal to. So in that case it break. Okay, if it is greater, the condition is not given as greater than or equal to. Even if it becomes equal to, it breaks. So now what happens? The current is pointing this and the previous is pointing this. So we have got the location of the data which you are searching. The node is formed. So now next we go to the if class. If current is not equal to null, no, it is not equal to null, and current data is equal to s data, yes, it is equal to. So what happens? It returns a 1. That is, the search value is present, else it returns 0. So suppose I am searching for 35 means, till it goes. So that in that case, current becomes equal to null. So what happens if current is not equal to null and current data is equal to only, it returns, else it has reached the null, as well as it is not equal to, the current data is not equal to s data means, it will return the value 0, which means this, the value which we are searching is not present. So now we'll go to the next one, insertion of a doubly linked list. Here what happens,